Next, Captain Finity shoots a young boy, and Eischied must save his right-hand man from a murder charge.
Are you saying you don't believe him? He'd just been attacked by three muggers that tried to kill him.
Next.
NBC. Stay tuned now as Eischied's right-hand man is accused of manslaughter. Next.
Through the synagogue, we go to community nursing homes to hold services. It's one thing I can do that makes a difference.
What's going on where people worship today? Caring, loving, working with others, doing what God wants you to do. Find yourself with people who worship. A message of Religion in American Life, the Ad Council, and this station.
On Disney, it's Gus the Pigskin Mule, who booted his pro football team to the Super Bowl. Starring Dick Van Patten, Tom Bosley, Ed Asner, Don Knotts, and Tim Conway. Sunday.
This is a News Center 5 update with Chuck Henry, sponsored by Diners Club.
South Korean President Park Chung-hee, his bodyguard, and four other men were shot and killed by the head of the Korean CIA during a dinner party. Mayor Byrne has found some city airport workers running a business on city time and using city equipment. We'll have more in a moment.
Monsieur, may I take your order, please?
Madame, monsieur, may I take your order,
this
please?
The way, this is my table.
But I saw them first.
What would you like to start?
The escargot is lovely.
Oh, go sit on the pastry tray. This is my table.
The escargot for two. Why don't you fold napkins?
It's easy to spot Diners Club members. Last year, they spent over $150 million on fine food and wine.
Madame, monsieur. May I take your order, please?
A Diners Club member. If you want to be one, call 800-525-7000.
The prime lending rate is going up again. A New York bank is now charging 15.25%. That's 5 points higher than a year ago. I'll have more news at 10.
BJ and the Bear.
Does he know what he's doing?
Sure does.
Are you the guy?
Yeah, I'm the guy.
BJ and the Bear, Saturday night on Channel 5.
At American, people are the difference. Last year, over 200,000 people applied here at the industry's first flight attendant college.
And Vicki Goetz is one of the few we accepted. We taught her to make your flight comfortable, reliable, and enjoyable. But we didn't have to teach her to be nice. We're American Airlines, and finding people like Vicki is one of the things we do best.
We're American Airlines, doing what we do best.
Hold it right there. Throw your gun down.
I'm a cop.
How many drinks did you have?
I wasn't drunk.
Finity's in big trouble. He lied to the investigators.
I didn't shoot a single, unarmed, helpless kid.
Ah! Right there.
Who's to say we just don't take it away from you?
Try it. I'll blow your face off.
How can you lose when you hit him with your facts?
I don't want a boy gunned down by a nigger-hating cop. Hang it up.
This roof to be closer to my head.
We're eavesdropping with hidden cameras as a big car owner test drives the new Dodge Aspen.
I know that this will get better mileage, perhaps, than my big car.
For under $5,000, the Aspen has six-passenger room, automatic transmission, power steering, white walls, and more.
It's just incredible that a car this lovely could sell for under $5,000.
See the new Aspen and test drive total performance from Dodge.
How do you spell relief?
When I get acid indigestion, I spell relief, R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief. Clinical tests prove with Rolaid you get relief Tums can't beat. That's right, relief Tums can't beat. In fact, relief no other leading antacid can beat. How do you spell relief?
For heartburn? I know. R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Relief no other leading antacid can beat.
Your life's work?
It's ready, Chief.
I've seen that. It's the same ring. All right, kill it.
Hot rod girls? How demented can you get?
Oh, about $6 million a year, tax-free. All right, listen to both of you. I want you to call all the borough COs and every precinct captain. Tell them to lay off this operation. Don't want anybody busting until we get the whole ring. Take this with me. I'm gonna get the DA to give us some wiretaps in the morning. 10 till 7. Kill Malfitano, I'm on my way. Well, call Irene for me, too. Tell her I'll be a few minutes late. Promise Alicia I'd go by the Bahama. Then we got a promotion party for Rudd.
Better tell Irene I'll be more than a few minutes late.
He's thirsty, old folk.
And you picked me up when I came in alone. But before you get ideas...
So the guy's sitting there. He's not cool.
Hey, who's mine in the store?
Hey,
I was looking for the chief.
You just missed him.
Oh, I got something for him.
Well, here, I'm sitting for you. You give us a minute.
Yeah, first thing in the morning.
Hey, sit down. Marge, make room for the captain.
All right, thank you. Thank you.
What are you drinking?
Scotch and water.
Hey, scotch and water for the captain.
Yeah.
Give him anything he wants and put it on his tab.
Would you like another drink?
Hi, I'm Marge.
Hi, I'm John Finnerty.
Great. Are you really a captain?
Yes.
Okay, yes, I am. About it. How about dinner?
Oh, thank you.
All right, maybe.
Well, congratulations.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Now what?
Now let's get us some wheels.
Is that what I know? What do you think? I got eyes in the back of my head?
Oh. You know, my roommate won't date cops.
No.
It's just the things that she's got about them.
Yeah.
But I don't feel that way.
I'm glad. Is that why she's not here?
You know where she is?
Mm-mm.
She's in Puerto Rico, living it up at the El Grande San Juan.
Mm.
Wow. What I wouldn't give to lie in the sun for a few days. But then I do have the apartment all to myself.
It's past 10.
It's late.
They serve coffee here?
I don't know. But I could fix you a cup over at my place. It's not far from here. 14th Street, near 7th.
I'd like to, but I can't. I gotta be in the office at 8 o'clock in the morning. Well, maybe some other time, huh?
Sure. Some other time.
Can I drop you off? I have my car.
No, that's okay.
Last of the big tippers.
Uptown. You got a lot to learn. Here you go before you lose your mind. Okay, guys, let's get us some wheels. Some big wheels. We ain't got all night.
Dressy for morning, noon, or evening. Suitable for all climates and a wide variety of activities.
Premier or no premier, I'll never let them talk me into a midnight fashion show again. Yeah, that looks pretty good.
Red hair,
Rose, push up the sleeves a little.
And matching scarf, making this outfit ideal.
Yeah, that's it. That's right. Okay, do me a favor. I know you love that little trinket, but... Oh, thank you. But just take it off, huh? All right? Thanks. Yeah.
Hi.
Hi. Do I look nervous?
Not a bit. I don't see how you miss.
Oh, Earl, it's not the girl. They're judging. It's the clothes.
That's what I meant.
I'm not going to make it. This shoe's at least three sizes too small.
Sabotage again. Marlena Budd, Earl Eischied.
Hi.
Hi.
What size do you need, nine? What I need right now is a joint.
Marlena, Earl is chief of detectives at NYPD.
Hi.
Of course. What else? You know what it's like when it's not your day?
No, it's not going to be my day unless you can make it once down that runway.
Be her.
Hold that, will you?
Yeah, it looks good. Tied, untied.
I tried.
Leave it untied. Huh?
What? Copy right there.
And stop eating
tacos. Irene.
The wrong number, right?
No, this may take a while.
Kennedy's been involved in a shooting.
Oh, no.
Captain Finity. Tonight, down there at that garage, were you drunk?
No.
But you had been drinking.
I had a drink at the office before I left.
You know, I had a drink tonight. And I bet you did, too.
Chief Eischied. How do you do, sir? My name is Martin Roth. I'm assistant district attorney.
It's a lousy break. You okay?
Mm-hmm. I'm fine, really.
Come on, I'll take it.
I'm okay.
Chief, if you don't mind, I have a few more questions I'd like to ask.
Look, it's late. The man's been through a lot.
We have an unarmed 13-year-old boy who was shot and killed by an off-duty policeman.
Who was brutally mugged by three assailants, one of whom had a gun to his head. That's after he caught them breaking a car window. You see, I was briefed by Sergeant Foley before I came in here.
This is Officer Sanchez's statement. He arrived on the scene seconds after the shots were fired. The only thing that he saw was Captain Finity standing over the body with a gun in his hand.
Are you saying you don't believe him? Because if that's what you're...
All I want is the facts. That's all. That's why I'm here. This is Officer Madden's statement. When he reached the scene, he saw Captain Finity staggering, and he had the strong smell of alcohol on his breath.
He had just been attacked by three muggers that tried to kill him. It's enough to make anybody stagger. Wouldn't you agree to that?
Yes, I would. If that's what happened.
All right, you want to call a police surgeon, determine if he's fit for duty, because that's the procedure, if there's some question. Go ahead, pick up the phone, call him. All right, come on, Kennedy.
It's over.
Come on.
I may need you to answer a few more questions in the morning.
Oh, okay.
Yes, tell the press I'll be ready to make a statement as soon as I go over my notes.
Barbara, you up?
I'm up now.
I don't think I can sleep with this cold. My throat's kind of sore.
All right, I'll get the aspirin and Sucrets.
Aspirin and Sucrets?
Aspirin for your other cold symptoms and for minor sore throat pain. Lots of doctors recommend Sucrets with a medicine for fast temporary relief. I'm glad one of us can sleep.
Aspirin and Sucrets, a sensible way to fight winter.
It wasn't love at first sight. A tampon without an applicator? Not me. But that woman gynecologist who designed Opie sure knew something. I found out Obi is tampon protection, pure and simple. It's rolled in layers that give you more from the tampon, and it doesn't need an applicator. It's simple and super comfortable. Obi tampons by a woman gynecologist and Johnson & Johnson. Tampon protection, pure and simple.
But I think more than that, in this market, you just got to capture a certain proportion and style.
Introducing America's newest personal car, Murata by Dodge.
Our Murata is a case in point, solid looking. Good image of the sporty cars of the past, but with one big difference. They've shed weight and they get fuel economy.
Murata is engineered to be fuel efficient, but not at the expense of styling or luxury.
I think it's a happy combination of a good style and a good value.
Test drive total performance from Dodge.
Jack Nicholson and Louise Fletcher star in the film that won 5 Oscars. One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. He's the rebellious patient.
What do you think you are, crazy or something?
Well, you're not.
She is the head nurse.
If Mr. McMurphy doesn't want to take his medication orally, we can arrange that he can have it some other way.
One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Sunday.
On Sports World, the big boys are rolling at the Charlotte National 500. Then it's the National Gymnastics Championships, plus the Legends of Bowling, Saturday on NBC.
All right, BC. All right now, buddy. Come on. It's a real good day. Here we go. Eat you. That's it. That. For him, you eat.
Eat.
Good morning.
Page one's already hit the fan. You got brush fires all over town.
Like who?
Now, take your pick. Your phone hasn't stopped ringing. You better start with Kimbrough.
He's expecting his office a half hour from now.
Are they forgetting the fact that that kid had a gun to his head?
Yeah, from the movie The Missing Gun, if you know what I mean.
Where's Finnerty now?
We got him looking at mug shots.
But I don't think it's going to do any good. You rarely find photographs of juvenile offenders under 16.
Look, Rick, I don't care what the percentage is. I want you to look for them. And check our undercover people. See if they're in surveillance photos of the neighborhood, you know, like schoolyard troublemakers, demonstrators, block parties, hell, anything.
Right. I'll get right on it.
I'll be in as soon as I can.
You're not gonna like this.
Oh. Vultures.
Look, I'm not interested in what the computer has to say, Elise. I don't believe that kid didn't have a rap sheet. And we have ways of finding out, so start digging. We'll check out all the DD files for the past 3 months, anything related to muggings. See if a nickel-plated 45 shows up.
I got it.
What about an ID on the other two?
Well, undercover had some pictures taken in connection with the vandalism of a junior high school about 2 blocks from where the deceased lived. Now, the pictures aren't real good, but Finnerty thinks he can identify one of the kids. But, Chief, he's not real sure.
Have Carol get on it right away. Tell her to hurry. It's all we've got.
Why is when something like this happens, neighbors, school teachers, they all say he was a model child?
I don't know. You know what this one's name was?
What?
Goody.
Goody. It figures.
You can mark my words. Somebody will swear it's an older boy.
Later editions get worse instead of better. Why didn't you call me last night?
You can thank Assistant D.A. Roth for this one.
I raised the roof with the D.A. He charges it to inexperience.
Well, Roth knew how to get his picture in the paper, right?
I spoke to Roth. He says it's worse than what the media is saying.
Roth doesn't know which end is up. Now, Finnerty was in a life-threatening situation. He had no choice.
Two uniformed officers on the scene within seconds saw only Finnerty standing over a body with a gun.
Suggesting what? That the kid was alone? Didn't have his two buddies with him?
He said Finnerty was drinking. Maybe drunk.
If Finnerty was drunk, he'd never be able to make up a story like that one. Now, somewhere out there, there are two punks with Finnerty's shield. Now, you just give me a couple of days and I'll find them.
It's not that simple, Earl.
We're talking about a captain of the force who's put in close to 20 years of time. Are you saying you won't give me a couple of days to work this out?
I'm saying I can't. Internal Affairs has already got it.
Then there's nothing more to say, then, is there?
Leave it alone, Earl. Let them do their job.
What's happening, Cole? This is my man, Cupcake.
What's the matter? And your nigger boys got school today?
Tell your friend to watch his mouth.
These boys are clients of mine. What's going on?
Well, it's about what we can do for you. We got this here 10.
Five-pointer, huh?
Yeah. 3 bills a day plus 10% of the score.
I think you've been took. Thing don't look real to me.
Nobody's asking you, Motormouth.
Looks real to me. Lieutenant shield I could use. A captain shield is tough.
Well, you snooze, you lose. We can do business uptown with this. Come on.
Hold on. What's your hurry? Look. I'll go an ace a day plus 10%.
A deuce, I forget it.
You ought to be thankful you're getting anything at all for this. Who's to say we just don't take it away from you?
Try it. I'll blow your face off.
Hey, he's kidding. Lighten up. Okay, you deuce. Half now, half tomorrow.
Didn't I give you a card?
Miss Gibbs, I'm Detective Carol Wright. May I speak to you for a moment? What about? Do you recognize this boy?
My brother, what about him?
Are your parents living in the city?
They're both dead. What has he done?
I just want to talk to him. Is he living with you?
Not anymore. Detective Wright, if you're looking for my brother, why did you find me?
The school records indicate that he does live with you.
Not anymore. Not for a long time.
Well, it's very important that we talk to him.
If it's so important, why don't you check with the juvenile detention center downtown? Uh-huh. My brother's an inmate there. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a lot of work to do.
Certainly.
Finity's in big trouble. He lied to the investigators. He didn't work late last night. He was over at the Bahama Bar with one of those chippy that works down the courts.
Finity? I don't understand this. Where is he?
They sent him home. Hold on.
Hold it.
Let's talk about it. I tried to help him out, but by the time I got the word, your friend, the assistant district attorney, Roth, had already jumped in with both feet.
What's that mean?
He was down there like Johnny on a spot. He climbed all over Finity. He made mincemeat out of him. A couple of guys told me later that they thought they'd have to put him in a rubber suit.
Earl, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Earl,
hold it. Hold it. Take it easy. Now, look. I'm not saying what he's doing is right. But Finity's been caught in a half a dozen lies already. It's getting worse. Every time he opens his mouth, now it's getting worse. Now, look, this isn't the first time it happened.
And the first time what? What are you talking about?
It wouldn't be the first time a cop got jittery and blew somebody away without just cause. Now, you know Finity and I know Finity, and I know you don't like to hear about the fact that...
So what you think happened?
What difference does it make what I think? What's more important, Earl, is that you uphold your end of it. Roth is going to run with this like a thief in the night. He's running down to the grand jury today and he's pressing for an indictment. Now, you got to watch yourself. Remember, when the sharks smell blood in the water, they look around for someone who's not on dry land.
Okay, I've been warned. I appreciate you coming by to see me yet.
Lazy! Come out of town, I'm on my way. Where's the Lazy?
Anything going for Finity, Chief?
Well, we turned up a credit card in that garage. Belongs to a woman who was mugged by kids. Could be the same ones.
Hey, that sounds good.
Yeah, except she's in intensive care and still unconscious.
Something, huh? Beer or something like that, maybe? Yeah.
You hear alarm?
Yeah. Excuse the way the place looks.
the wife's in Wisconsin, yeah.
Her sister just had a hysterectomy. A young woman, too. You wouldn't think that a woman that age would have to go through something like that. You don't think this made the papers in Wisconsin, do you?
You didn't tell her anything about this, did you?
Oh, no, she's got enough to worry about with her sister. I was hoping it would all be over by the time she got back. you heard about this morning.
Yeah, I heard about this morning. Now I want to hear about it from you. Finnerty, why the hell didn't you tell him you were at the Bahama Bar in the first place?
Well, I didn't think it was that important, and, I was a little upset.
Upset or drunk?
I wasn't drunk.
Do you realize you lied to the DA?
Okay, so I lied.
How many drinks did you have?
A few. I don't remember.
Well, the bartender remembers. So's that sweet young thing you were with.
Hey, Earl, I've been married for 23 years. In all those years, I never once... I don't want to hurt Ruthie. I don't want her to know about that.
Know about what? Did you take her home and sleep with her?
No, I didn't. I was thinking about it.
You protecting the girl? Is that why you shot that kid?
No, no.
He was alone, wasn't he?
No!
Well, how many others were with him? Two, three, four?
Two. There were two.
But you're not sure, are you?
Yes, I'm sure.
If you saw them again, would you recognize them?
Yes.
How did it feel when you pulled a gun on the kid?
What are you talking about? I was on the ground, struggling.
Is that why you killed him? Because he knocked you down?
He had a gun.
And you thought he had a gun. You had a lot to drink, remember? You probably thought he was going for a gun, so you shot him.
What are you doing to me? Force has been my life. He had a gun to my head.
If he had a gun, we would have found the gun.
Well, one of the others took it.
Took it? Took it where? Now, surely you must have seen them run.
No, 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 I was dazed.
You mean drunk, don't you?
No, you mean drunk. I never said I was drunk.
Now, how many others were there? Two, three, four, five, what?
Two, I told you, there were two.
But you're not sure, are you? Do you know what they looked like? What they were wearing? Could you go into a court of law and testify against them?
I don't know. I'm not sure what they look like now, or what they were wearing, or how I'll do in court when the time comes. I'll just have to find that out. All I'm sure of right now is there were three of them, and they were going to kill me. I worked for you for 9 years, Earl, but I've been a cop for 19. The department can do a lot to me. They can fire me, maybe send me to prison, but they can't make me roll over and fess up to something I didn't do. And I didn't shoot a single, unarmed, helpless kid. You're in my house now, Earl. I'd appreciate it if you left. What's so funny?
I guess I just wanted to hear you say that. You know, if you hadn't taken so long, if you told the truth in the first place, we wouldn't have to go through all this.
Let me tell you what we found out so far.
Yeah.
We've identified that kid you picked out of the surveillance photo. They call him Cupcake.
I don't want to see any reporters, Earl.
Relax, relax.
Hello, Chief. Just heard from Alisi. Roth just got an indictment from the grand jury against Finity. Negligent homicide. We got to take him in, Chief.
Anything turn up on those kids?
Yeah. Turns out Footy has a rap sheet on him that reads like a phone book. Took a little arm twisting, but we finally got the petitions filed against him. He and two others, Cupcake, the one Finity picked out, and another named Executioner, were all wards of the Juvenile Detention Center.
Chief Eischied calling. Is he in? Thank you. He's in a meeting.
Yeah, I'll bet he is. Let me guess, those kids, they escaped, right?
Walked out is more like it.
You make this copy?
No.
I did.
Oh,
I went down there. The kids use that place as their base of operations. They come and go as they please. I don't understand it.
Well, it's not hard to understand. Those kids, they know they're under 16, so they know they can get away with murder.
The juvenile authorities having a thing on them. Are you ready for this? Over 30% of their records are missing. A girl I went to school with works in probation. The name Executioner rang a bell. She dug up files on both of them. Between Goody and the Executioner, they have a record of over 50 arrests, including, catch this, three homicides. Cab drivers.
Which goes hand in hand with what I got from the DD5s. Four muggings and three cab holdups in the past 6 weeks by three kids. One of them had a nickel-plated 45. Oh, and there's one more thing. That credit card, that woman was mugged on 72nd Street.
Can she identify them?
No, she's in a coma. It's 50-50, but I think it's the same three kids.
Sounds like it. But knowing who they are and bringing them in is two different things. Those kids are streetwise. They know how to survive in the city. But you've done good, both of you.
Chief Eischied's office. Yes, sir. The assistant DA.
Roth Eischied.
It's an unpleasant fact, Chief, and I'm afraid it's one that we're both going to have to face.
Roth, you're not prosecuting a case. You're staging an event. Now, just what the hell was he supposed to do? He's attacked by three kids.
I don't believe that. I believe that there was only one. I think this is a situation where a bigoted policeman overreacted because he was drunk.
Just where in the hell did you pick up that instant bigoted profile on someone you just met a few days ago?
Finnerty saw the youth breaking into the car. But instead of just arresting him, he started pushing his weight around until he finally shot him. This was an unarmed 13-year-old boy. There's no justifiable cause to take that boy's life.
That's some scenario you got going for you, Roth.
Well, it'll stand up in court, I guarantee it.
Oh, sure it will. How can you lose when you hit him with your facts? An altar boy gunned down by a nigger-hating cop. Hang it up. Politicians.
All right. I want to get started on that taxicab thing. That's the only hope we've got.
No. Come on. We've been around a couple of times. You and I, we've done business before. No, it's plain and simple, that's all. No. You want them, you want them, you want them, that's all. But just don't jerk me around, you know what I mean?
Oh, right there. All right, you're all under arrest. We don't, nobody move. Stay put.
Look, 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 officer. I had no idea, no idea what was going on here.
Just visiting, right? Don't make me laugh, I have a hernia.
Well, isn't there some way where we can straighten this out?
Now, there might be some way we can work this out. But it'll cost you.
All right, we're taking a very long shot here. But it may be the only way of proving Finnerty's story is true. Now, recent series of cab holdups involved three juveniles with a nickel-plated 45. Now, they fit the description Finnerty gave us. And the M.O. on all the cab holdups is the same.
One of them usually picks up a cab around 96th and Broadway. Takes it on uptown where the others are waiting. Now, don't be fooled by their ages.
The one sent to pick up the cab could be as young as 10 years old. Now, you're to assume that they are all armed and dangerous. Any questions? All right, that's it.
Look at these
cabs.
I think
of hunger. Well, I got my eye on that one right there.
How can you tell that's good?
Well, before I was accepted to the academy, I used to drive these babies six nights a week.
Big deal.
Ruthie, why didn't you call? I could have come to the airport.
I just took the first plane that was available. I wasn't sure what time I'd be here.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have called you.
It's all right. It's all right, John. Everything will be all right.
I wanted to call, but...
You don't have to explain anything. Chief Eischied phoned me and he told me what had happened.
I'm not sure he had the right to do that.
He felt that you needed me. He was right.
How could I say it on a telephone? If I hadn't stopped for a couple of drinks, if I hadn't talked to a girl from the office... I didn't want you to think...
I didn't think it for a minute. I have trusted you for 23 years. I couldn't have been wrong all that time. You should have known that.
Oh, Ruthie. Oh, Ruthie. I just had the stupid idea that you might not come back. Or if you did, you might not stay. It's funny what a man can think when he's alone at 3 o'clock in the morning.
You're not alone now. And we're gonna see this through together. You're such a good man. They're not gonna take that away from you.
Oh, I'm glad you're here.
I
110 between Lexington and 3rd.
Right.
I just picked up a fare going to 110th and Lexington.
Change for 20.
Police, hold it!
Come on, man, let's go!
Get your name! This is Law. Made contact with the suspects at 110th near Lexington. I'm in pursuit.
Pull any punches, Earl. We're not ready for trial tomorrow. They got an unarmed boy. They're going to get a lot of mileage out of the fact that Finity was drinking, and they've got two police officers arriving seconds after the shot who saw only Finity. I need something. Anything on the shield?
No.
What about that woman?
She's still in a coma. There's nobody on the street can identify them. They're just too fast.
I need those two kids, Earl. Without them, we don't have a case.
He didn't tell Finnerty that. Look, I want them as badly as you do. I've reached out to just about every detective in the city. Got a lot of good men out there looking. Well, we appreciate what you're doing. Thank you.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Hey.
20 more detectives will be covering the area tonight.
You on a copy of the list?
Yeah.
That's good. Let's keep it that way.
Ambrose's been after me about assigning too many men.
I'm gonna get that.
Yeah.
Eischied's office, Elise. Yeah, hold on.
Delisandro, you didn't order a bust on that porno ring, did you?
No. Delisandro?
Chief, it's about that bust. I already filed my report, but I wanted to tell you personally. I think I got my signals crossed.
Look, I didn't order a bust. Who made the arrest?
Well, that's the thing. There wasn't any arrest. They just took the film. One of your vice captains.
Delisandro, get your tail in here as soon as you can.
Phony bust?
Yeah, but here's the catch. Whoever did it was sporting a captain's shield.
Infinity shield?
That's what we gotta find out.
Yeah. Chief Eischied's office, Elise speaking. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay, thanks, Borzio, I will. Yeah, yeah, later. That was Gorman and Borzio. Now, they've been keeping an eye out on Cupcake's sister, Vera Gibbs. Nothing's been going on, but the other day, a guy across the street said he saw the kid there.
I wanna talk to her personally. Turn off a ton of them on my way down.
Right.
Well, when Delisandro gets here, see if you can get a description of the guy who made that phony bust. And start reaching out to our informants on the west side. I want the word put out that somebody from out of town is here to buy films. And hopefully that'll lead us to the guy with the shield.
The first time my brother was arrested, he was 11 years old. Along the way, they lost his records a dozen times, changed the color of his eyes, forgot his address. The one thing he did learn was how to manipulate the system perfectly.
When was the last time you saw him?
6 months ago.
Want some coffee?
No, thank you.
Anything else? Your brother was seen leaving the building where you live.
Well, that's not my responsibility.
He's a ward of the Juvenile Correctional Center. Did you check with them? At $6,500 per year per child, you think they know where he is?
Well, they don't know.
That, of course, doesn't bother you.
No, at the moment, you're concerned with protecting one of your own. That's why the chief of detectives is so interested in a black 14-year-old, isn't it?
Vera, if you know where your brother is, you could be charged with obstruction of justice. Now, your brother's wanted for a criminal offense.
Criminal?
Yes.
I'll tell you what's criminal. My brother's probation officer, who sees him once a week, shares a joint and tells him to be cool.
But your brother doesn't become less dangerous just because you got a pretty good case against the system.
When he was in school, they encouraged his truancy because he was a troublemaking spade.
I'm not a school teacher, I'm a cop. But I've seen some of the victims of these troublemakers. So is this hospital too, I imagine.
When he first got in trouble, I thought he could help. They sent him to a doctor who saw him once a week for 10 minutes. I checked up on that good doctor. He was on 16 different state and city payrolls. Talk about victims. The more trouble my brother gets in, the more people get rich.
I don't make excuses for that. I hate it as much as you do. But in that respect, your brother is a victim of greed. And greed doesn't discriminate whether against blacks or whites.
What chance does my brother have? Will you answer me that?
What chance did you have? You came out of the same family. You go to college, you work here 40 hours a week, you pay your bills.
Which almost makes me a card-carrying member of the establishment. Dr. Tobin's No. You're asking me to rat on my own brother, who doesn't have a chance in hell.
All right. You want to wait until he ends up on a slab with a tag on his toe? Okay. Fine with me.
Get yourself a cup of coffee, Junior. I'll watch you stand for you. That's 100. Count it.
100. Right. What about the 10? What about a percentage?
I'll take care of that right now. You should have your bread in a few hours.
We'll be at the pool room waiting for you. You can count on that.
Chief, this is Alisi. One of our informants has made contact with a guy who has some porno films to sell.
All right, what else?
We just set up a buy. The seller sounds like he's carrying his films around with asbestos gloves.
Sounds like the one we want. Where is he?
I'm on 8th Avenue, 46th Street. Manny's peep shows. Should be open in about 10 minutes.
Okay, I'm on my way. You and Louis take the front. Delisandro and I'll be waiting for him inside.
Could be our man coming in now, Chief.
Okay, Lisi. Look over the back room.
May I help you, sir? That's it.
Police, don't move.
Where you going?
Somebody asked me to deliver it. I haven't any idea what's in it.
I'm not giving a damn about the contents in the suitcase. Just yet. What I want to know is where'd you get the captain's shield?
I don't know what you're talking about.
The Cadillac Hotel. Does that ring a bell?
Never been there.
Mister, you got 8 rolls of film in that suitcase. That makes you a distributor. That's a serious charge.
I'll make parole. Now, do I get to call my lawyer or what?
Go ahead. But if you pick up that phone, you better be prepared to spend a long time in the slammer. And if by some miracle you do beat the rap, I'm going to spread the word to the family that you've been ripping them off.
What happens if I tell you what you want to know?
In my cigar. Well, I accidentally light a couple of those films. That leaves you with six. The law allows you six for personal reasons. No big deal.
All right. Got the shield from two kids.
Yes, sir. Okay, folks, let's step back, please.
Ready? Yeah.
Stand over there, please.
Do it now, take the back.
Just keep these people back. There they are.
In light of recent evidence presented to the district attorney's office, the prosecution recommends that all charges against Captain Finnerty be dropped.
The motion is accepted. The court stands adjourned.
Thank you.
Hey, guys.
I can't help it. My knees are shaking.
There's nothing to cry about. Everything's gonna be okay.
Chief? I just wanted to let you know that I'm very happy about the way that things turned out. Believe it or not, I had nothing against Finnerty or his shield. Seems like I was pushing hard while I was just doing my job. Well, all right, okay, I'm ambitious. I realize that. I'm not apologizing. I thought this would be a feather in my cap. But I also thought this case needed to be prosecuted to its fullest.
Tell me something, Roth. When you make it to the governor's mansion, are you going to give a damn about the people, the victims? Or are you going to keep turning these kids loose as fast as we can catch them? I'm going to keep my eye on you, Roth.
Chief, what if we keep an eye on each other?